That's looking so cool, man. I'm gonna upload that to my Instagram story. Show everyone what music I'm into. So that was me doing an impression of every one of my friends that's been doing it lately.
For those of you that haven't seen it, there's a new Instagram trend that's gone crazy. People are using a photo of Bill Clinton with a bunch of records to let their friends know what their favorite albums are.
I was like blown away. I didn't realize that all my friends were so good at Photoshop until I realized that there was an internet generator that let you Photoshop the album artwork in. Like 3 days ago, no one knew anything. And then all of a sudden, the very next day, it's just like it's a standard, just sort of a weird idea. I'm gonna recreate this photo. I've just picked out some records. Lol, when you're putting on a suit and you stink, but you look fly. Probably look more spider or another insect that's not as desirable. If you said to someone, oh, hey mate, you're looking a bit mosquito today, they'd be like, looking at you like, what? But if you said, oh, you're looking fly, they'd be like, oh, chin. I'm like, what is with them? Let's try and recreate the photo.
She see money all around me.
This will be like a 5 day thing. We'll all be over it, like the face app. And what albums was he holding when he did the original one? Like, he wouldn't have been holding any Kanye. But yeah, let's do a bit of research. I'm gonna fire up the computer. I think if I search Bill Clinton vinyl photo, I wanna try and figure out the origins of this. Maybe story? History? His story? What about the she story? Why is it called his story? Why can't it be herstory? Isn't that another example of how our society is, you know, biased towards men? What you need is the middle ground. It-story or person-story. I reckon that might be the original. Who's this? Joan Jett. I have no idea who this artist is. So in 1999-ish, find out who she was under YouTube.
How do you make everyday
omelettes
much tastier?
Just add much. I don't know how you make everyday omelettes much tastier. Okay. I can't imagine Bill Clinton listening to this. Pretty sick though, pretty sick. I'm impressed by Bill Clinton. Oh, that was a weird one. It was like a point and then a thumb up. That could be a new one. Like, it's good for social situations if you throw out the point and then you realize, oh, no, we're going with thumbs up. You're not committing to either of them. If you do the point without the thumb there, that's no man's land. But if you at least whip out that point with the thumb up, it's really easy to convert it into that other one. So I'd recommend that. You can, like, it's such a versatile move. In conclusion, this will be gone in 2 to 3 days. So let's enjoy it while it lasts. Thank you so much for watching today's video. It's been brought to you by me. Because I'm a very small YouTuber with 300 subscribers. Thank you to every one of you, of course. There's not many of us, but that doesn't matter, you know. What we lack for in size, we make up for in, what do we make up for it in? Something really good. I've been watching a few videos on how to do YouTube lately. Apparently you should say at the end of the video something about, oh, everyone, do a comment. So maybe we could all do a little comment at the bottom of the video for a bit of fun. See what everyone's four albums would be. What would you have picked if you were doing the challenge? Bye, goodbye, see ya. That was terrible. Oh, whoops. See ya later.